You know, when it comes to ADS-B upgrades, we hear a lot from manufacturers and why their equipment may be better than the next, but one thing we don't hear a lot of is input from shops. These are the folks on the front line actually putting this stuff in. Now here at Aviation Consumer, in the coming year, we're going to step up our field reporting of ADS-B upgrades and visit some of these busy shops to learn more about buying trends and how those shops are dealing with the demand. In this video, we'll start on coastal New England with NexAir Avionics. I'm here with Brian Wolf. He's the avionics manager at NexAir Avionics, a busy avionics shop in Plymouth, Massachusetts, just outside of Boston. And in about 16 months or so, we're not going to be able to go too many places in this Boston airspace without ADS-B output. In this video, we're going to talk to Brian to learn a little bit more about what his busy shop is seeing in ADS-B demand with some tips on how you might upgrade if you haven't upgraded yet. Let's go down to the hangar floor to do that, and then we'll come back up here to the cockpit and talk a little bit about validating that ADS-B installation from a flight test standpoint.
Yeah, so ADS-B upgrades are the name of the game, a big talk right now. Most of our customers we see are interfacing WASP navigators or installing a WASP navigator at the same time as ADS-B equipment. And we've done retrofits on all different types of aircraft here at NexAir. Anything from Stearman's all the way up through your light to mid-sized jet market.
Now the first step is determining which ADS-B out technology best suits your flying, either a 978 UAT transceiver or a 1090 ES ADS-B transponder, which is required at or above 18,000 feet.
Yeah, so 978. So we see 978 ADS-B upgrades with our customers that already have digital transponders, just want the quick and easy out, really only do local VFR flying, but don't quite want to give up leaving airspace. As for the 1090 stuff, which is the majority of what we do here at NexAir, we see our customers that are planning on traveling, possibly outside of the country, a lot of people above 18,000 feet, always in the Part 25 market, and it's fairly popular in the Part 23 market as well.
Now NexAir confirmed what other shops are reporting, and that's that WASP GPS upgrades are on the rise, co-installed with ADS-B, and it's likely for traffic and weather display.
WASP for number one. To be able to do a WASP LPV approach, anybody who's been flying ILSs for years, it's a huge thing to add to their cockpit. Along with other benefits, displays of ADS-B, weather and traffic, if it's available, you know, based on the customer's choices, iPad interfaces, all these things come with WASP navigators paired with ADS-B.
On the other hand, our advice is to start with the basics first, especially if you've been overlooking the required two-year transponder certifications. Its health could determine your ADS-B upgrade path.
Transponder checks and pedostatic checks are a must by every airplane over. By 24 months, you need to comply with both of those checks. We see that a lot of the ADS-B market, they want to pair UAT boxes with their current transponders, which is good as long as they have good working transponders. So we encourage people to have a good check done on their transponders, make sure it's a good working digital transponder before installing any UAT solution. If they don't have a solution or a digital transponder, something that may be on the way out, there's plenty of good new products that can replace that transponder and have great two-year warranties on them with a lot of different manufacturers.
Now, if you've been putting off an ADS-B upgrade because you can't deal with the downtime, it's not uncommon to wait months just to get on a shop schedule, and that likely won't improve as the demand increases.
So with ADS-B on the horizon, lots of people are thinking scheduling. Here at NexAir, we're booking anywhere from 3 to 4 months out, which roughly puts us into the October-November range. So the 16 months is coming up quickly for the ADS-B mandate. ADS-B downtime varies with the type of aircraft and the type of solution you're going with. Anything from a simple 978 solution up to a Part 25 solution. We say most of our small 978, smaller aircraft customers, anywhere from 2 to 5 days of downtime Our Part 25 customers, we see anywhere from 3 to 8 weeks, depending on what solution they choose and what's going to be paired in the airplane.
And finally, no ADS-B out job is complete until it's fully tested on the ground and even in the air.
Not done until it's flight tested and validated. What's the process there once the airplane comes out of the hangar?
Yeah, so here a lot at NexAir, we do a lot of the flight testing ourselves, but there are certain type of airframes that we aren't all checked out in. So what we see is in the Garmin installation manual, Avionine installation manual, there's always some kind of post-checkout procedure, whether it's going into your local Mode C Vale and doing some turns and some climbs, ascents, or it's, you know, all of them are required to leave with transponder checks, but a lot of it is testing, you know, basically the output of the ADS-B and the quality of the signal down to the stations.
And of course, if you're not sure whether it's working or not, you could always get an ADS-B ATC report.
Right, so they have those reports all on the FAA website, FAA.gov, and it measures the levels of ADS-B. So anything red, we should be concerned, but most of the time they're clear or white boxes showing that that's a good check, and that's it.
For Aviation Consumer Magazine, this is Larry Anglesano reporting. Thanks for watching.